to Games Master. Now, what many men don't understand today is there comes a time in every man's life when he must put aside laddie pursuits, settle down, hang up his football boots, and find himself a wife. For that reason, I've been saying all week that at the end of the show, I will marry one of the mermaids. Unfortunately, we did that gag last year when I married Wickfield. Sorry, ladies. However, we can console ourselves with the fact that later on in the show, two of the country's finest cricketers, Adam Holyoake and Phil Tufnell, will be showing us their googlies, and we'll continue this marital theme with an event we call Till Death Do Us Part.
My event today is on the all-action beat-em-up Die Hard. My two contestants had the formidable task of playing through all 20 levels of this game. As this is such a difficult challenge, I've given them two bites of the cherry. They each have an energy bar at the top of the screen, which decreases as they get hit. When it has decreased twice, that would normally be game over. Today, though, I'll award them two further energy bars, which will give them a fighting chance. Okay, Bruce. Yippee-ki-yay.
And so, nuptial niceties are nearing their nadir for Tony and Madeline King.
Welcome to the show, Tony. Welcome, Madeline.
Right, now, how long have you been married, you two?
5 years.
Have you argued a lot? Have you ever split up, anything like that?
Only had one problem once, didn't we?
Yeah,
we, that's fair. Both trying to give up smoking. Mm-hmm. It lasted 3 months. We ended up getting so stressed that we split up.
But you obviously got back together again?
Both started smoking and got back together.
And that was it? And so smoking has been the key to your happiness?
Yeah, that's
right.
Yeah.
Next message for all the young people out there. Okay, well, best of luck. If you'd like to assume your positions by the game, then I'll head commentary position wards. And aiding and abetting me, gamey-wise, is Dave Perry. Dave, is it true that Die Hard films are based on your own life?
Well, that's something I've always tried to keep a bit of a secret. You've obviously been speaking to Bruce.
Because you, as well, have worn the same vest for 10 years.
that's very true, yes.
What about the first couple of stages of the game we're going to see, first of all? What tips can you give Tony and Madeline?
Well, obviously, when you start off, this is a very, very tough challenge, and we're only going to give them one continue to finish the whole game in. So the main thing they've got to do is keep out of close contact combat. If they can pick up weapons and use them, then they should use them because they want to keep hang on to their energy for the really tough bosses later on.
Okay, just to reiterate again, they have to get right through the end of the game and rescue the president's kidnapped daughter using only one continue. Best of luck, Tony. Best of luck, Madeline. You have the rest of the show. And your time starts now. And here comes the first guy. Screen-wise, at the top left, you can see Tony's energy bar. That will go all the way down. Green-wise, then it will turn red all the way down. When that happens, that's one game gone. Madeline's is a similar one in the top right-hand corner. Because we believe in sexual stereotypes, Tony is playing the boy and Madeline is playing the girl. When the baddies come on, you can see their energy bars as well. A good start from them, Dave.
Yeah, they're handling it very well at the moment. Tony's taking the most hits, as you can see. There's the most red showing on his energy bar. And the game itself plays very much like Streets of Rage, where you move through and you have these energy bars you have to wear down on the bosses, but you've got all the moves in there and combinations that you find in a Virtua Fighter game.
Okay, now, is there going to be lots of objects like that he's picked up there? What is that, some kind of broom?
Yeah, that's a very large pole. I think that's the best way to discover it. It's called a broom.
I'm very familiar with large poles, Dave.
So, but you see, they've both got weapons now, and the thing they have to do is just keep their opponents at bay. That way, they won't take too many hits, because they've got some very big bosses to face later on.
Okay, that's one stage done. Tony and Madeline have still got another 19 to go. The action's getting very, very hot and sweaty here. While I deodorise Dave's pits, let's go to today's news. Following last week's Virtua Fighter 3 event, we've got an exclusive look at the only serious arcade contender in the pipeline. It may look like Tekken 2, it may smell like Tekken 2, but these are in fact world-exclusive pictures of the much-awaited Tekken 3. Still in development and without sound effects, Namco felt hairy enough to invite Games Master to their offices a couple of weeks ago to be the first people outside of Japan to preview one of the games of the year. Set 20 years after Tekken 2, it sees the return of six of the old crew, who now sport a whole new bunch of tricks. Of course, there are new characters like the beautiful Lin Shaolin and the brutal Ring, who turns out to be the son of Nin and Kazuma. Still with me?
But those expecting complex split-level fighting environments like Virtua Fighter 3 will be disappointed. It's as flat as 3-day-old pop. However, on the core, look at that, and the ooh, I bet that hurt scales, the designers have come up trumps. Expect it in arcades in March, or complain to me.
Perfect. Welcome back. We're in the middle of our Till Death Do Us Part event. Tony and Madeline King trying to get right through Die Hard before the end of the show. There are 5 levels, 4 stages in each level. They're at present on level 2, stage 2. Now, lots of guys in very bad yellow kind of Oasis-like cagoule hooded tops there.
It's like a throwback from the movie Outbreak, isn't it? But what they can do is they've got to watch this hose as well coming from the fire engine, because that'll knock them over and damage them. And there's a gun on the floor, there's a machine gun now that Madeline can pick up. But Tony's been a bit cowardly. He's hanging back with his pistol and Madeline's in there.
He's letting Madeline take a kick in now.
She's in there taking a kick, but she's got a machine gun now. This is payback time.
No, she can't actually shoot Tony, though. She might want to at this point, but not yet.
I think she wants to. She's aiming at him. He's running away, but she can't do him any damage. He's been hit by the fire engine hose, so that's justice.
Okay, so at the moment, they're still doing battle with the fire engine. Contractually, though, I only have to spend a certain amount of time standing next to Dave in one show, so I'm going to escape into today's celebrity challenge. Let's go over to Games Master and find out what it is.
It was on my most recent trip to California that I discovered the rather entertaining attraction that formed the basis of today's event. A wicked baseball game that challenges contestants to hit the ball out of the park. 2 contestants will both face 6 pitches. The winner will be the one who hits the balls the biggest total distance. To warm them up, the first 2 balls will be pitched in practice mode. Then they'll face 2 from a minor league pitcher, and finally, 2 from a devastating major league fast arm. Bring out the cheerleaders. I'm feeling like a big swinger today.
Okay, our guests tonight, like me, are used to bowling a maiden over. Please welcome the potential of future English cricket captain, plus the bad boy of English cricket, Adam Holyoake and Phil Tufnell.
Welcome to the show, Adam.
Thanks for coming on, Phil. Now, you're not playing cricket tonight, you're playing baseball. What do you both think about the American version of our rounders, then, Adam?
Oh, well, it's bat ball games. Can't be too much different to cricket, I suppose.
Maybe one or two. Phil, what about you? I mean, is it as good as cricket in any way, baseball?
Well, yeah, I mean, I watch a little bit of it. On the telly, and it looks a pretty good game, you know.
Can you adapt any of your own wonderful batting techniques then to baseball?
Well, we'll have to see. I'm looking forward to sort of like giving a few home runs here.
Uh-huh. And what is your highest score for England again?
22.
22. Okay, then. Right. Okay, we're going to take a short break now while we make sure none of our balls have been tampered with. Coming up in the second half, we have Phil and Adam on the baseball as well as the climax of our special Till Death Do Us Part Die Hard Challenge. We'll be back in a few seconds. Not a bad show, actually, if I don't mind saying so myself. We have got Tony and Madeline King at the moment playing through the arcade game at Die Hard. And we're joined by 2 special guests tonight representing the full age spectrum of English cricket. Young, fresh-faced Adam Holyoake, wily, seasoned old pro Philip Tufnell, about to do battle on the old baseball. Joining me in the comedy box is Rick Henderson. Rick, Philip Tufnell is the bad boy of English cricket. You're the bad boy of Games Master co-commentators.
Oh, I'm just bad, Dominic, actually.
Okay, now, you don't think this is going to be a terribly close challenge, do you?
Well, Adam is the new great white hope of English cricket, and Phil is not exactly batsman extraordinaire.
He quite literally bats at number 11.
Yeah, he bats at number 11 for England. So
how can you help him out?
Well, basically, it's get the bat level and straight. Don't top the ball, don't bottom the ball, watch where the ball's coming from and wear a not too tight a pant, because otherwise you'll get some splittage.
Okay, thank you very much, Rick. Okay, the way we're doing this challenge is each player is going to get 2 strikes on 3 different levels, starting on a rookie and ending up in the major leagues. Whoever has the most feet measured at the end will walk home with a golden joystick. Adam is first up on rookie level. Best of luck, Adam. Take your 2 rookie strokes. Okay, so up goes Adam for stroke 1. And that's a good hit, Rick, outside of the park! He's got a home run on the Adam, please make way for Phil. Okay, Rick, great technique there from Adam Hollyoak.
Yeah, he was extraordinarily graceful. He didn't put an awful lot of power in it, but he hit the ball cleanly, and that is what you've got to do.
Okay, best of luck, Phil. Take your first hit.
Here comes the
pinch. He swung at it. That's good enough, man. He's off. Number 11 batsman belaying his batting position, 527 feet. And here comes Phil's second stroke. Here comes the ball, he swings, and it's not quite as good as the first one. 4 foot for Mr. Tufnell. He ends up just now with 531 foot. Please swap with Adam. Now, Phil's technique not quite as nice as
Adam's. Now, he's trying to slog the ball out of the park, but missing the ball entirely sometimes. That's the problem, that's the problem.
A little less power and a little bit more thought, Rick.
Yeah, a little bit more thought. Cleverer baseball is required.
Okay, so at the end of the first level, Adam on 957 foot, Philip slightly behind on 531 foot. We're going to move up now to minor league level where the pitches will be slightly trickier. So Adam, take your first minor league pitch.
Here comes the pitch.
So they're going to get slightly harder now, these. He swings, oh, that's not as good. 130 feet, a little bit trickier now, Rick.
Yeah, it's a lot trickier. You're getting curveballs and you're getting faster shots here.
Okay, Adam, your next one. That's a bit better. Is it going to be another home run? It's another home run. He smashed the clearing.
He's hit it so far into the atmosphere.
So a 535-foot homer for Adam Hollyoak, added to 130 foot for the previous shot, takes up to a grand total so far of 1,622 feet. Adam, please make way for Phil. Okay, now Rick, again, nice technique on that second shot from Adam.
Superb technique on the second shot. He read the ball the second time. The first time, it was going a bit faster and it took a little time to adjust.
Now, as far as Phil's concerned for this level now, what is the best thing you could do? They're going to be harder pitches for him.
Concede.
Okay then, Phil, you are just over 1,000 points behind, so we're really looking for two homers from you here. Best of luck. Take your first minor league pitch. Oh, that's not bad.
Oh, good.
Oh, that's a homer in the minors. Oh, that's a into the heavens, Rick.
It's into the heavens. It's called rain.
Quite literally causing rain there. Okay, Mr. Philip Tufnell, take your second minor league strike. Oh, it's a little bit shorter again than the first one. It's a 1 foot. It's a little dinky one there. So 1 foot added to 538 feet. Oh, that'll be 539. And if we add that to Phil's score from round one, it gives him a total of 1,070. Phil, make way for Adam, and let's talk to the majors. So, Rick, Adam, 552 feet ahead. But Phil can still win this.
Phil can win it. If Adam strikes twice or does a complete nightmare, then Phil, all he has to do is get two home runs.
What's the most you can get for a home run?
It's 600 foot, actually, so he's going to have to hit it to Swansea.
OK, well, I haven't seen Phil so far. I think he's capable of it. Right.
I think so.
OK, what's going to be different about the major league then? What's the pitchers going to be like?
Well, they're going to be fast. You're not going to see them. It's going to be a blur, and they're going to be curving all over the place. We're talking West Indian pitchers here.
OK, thank you very much, Rick. So, let's go to round three then. The major league, Adam Hollyoak. Could you take your first strike? Oh, it is getting trickier now. Only 12 foot. Mr. Tufnell still in with a shout. Take your second pitch, please, Adam. Oh, he's building up nicely there. A 12 footer and a 15 footer. 27 in total scored. Takes Adam's score up to 1,649 there. Adam, please make way for Phil. Okay, so Phil is 579 points behind Adam, Rick. It's all building up very nicely. What does he need then?
Well, everything's possible now. He only needs two fly balls in park or a home run and
a kind of
nothing,
big,
really. Yeah, just a little bunt.
Okay, then. Best of luck, Phil. Please take your first major league strike. He swings. Oh, it's a strike, but he can still do it, Rick.
He can still technically do it, but he needs a 600-footer.
Okay, Phil, take your final strike. It's a home run! It's a home run! And a
be 6 feet. Adam Holyoake is the winner. Okay, gentlemen, let's go to you first, Adam. Only 46 foot in it at the end. When you were sitting down there watching Phil prepare to take his last swing, were you nervous at all?
I was, actually. I know his capabilities as a baseballer, and I was worried all the way.
Uh-huh. Bit of betting his capabilities as a cricket batsman. Then.
If it was cricket, I wouldn't have been worried at all.
Now, Phil, do you think you deserve maybe a move up the batting order now because of that?
Well, I think I like the batting to the... to the batsman of the team, I think.
That's probably a wise thing upon reflection there. So, well, thanks very much, both of you, for coming on. We only have one joystick, and it goes to Adam Holyoake. You know what boys are like? Me, Phil and Adam are going to go off and compare the size of our boxes. Let's go over to Dave and find out how the Die Hard Challenge is going on. Dave.
Well, whilst you've been away, it's been all action on our Die Hard Challenge. These are some key moments from the game. First, we're going to level 2, stage 4. And this is the moment when Madeline loses her first plus life. She has to use a continue to carry on with the challenge. Of course, both our challenges are allowed to use 2 continues. Here in the fountain, the fighting's going on. And there we go, Madeline's life flashing at the top. She's got to use a continue. That's it. So Madeline has now used 50% of her allotted energy for the whole challenge. Going to move on now to level 3, stage 3. And this is the part where I thought they were both going to come a cropper, because these renegades from Rise of the Robots are really very, very tough indeed. That's one of our robots down. Very, very tricky moment. And Tony is very, very low with his energy at the top as well. He's down to his last bar on his first continue. So it's looking dodgy, but they're still alive.
Okay, just to be checked to see how you are doing, Tony, how is your state of Mary Bliss holding up to the rigours of the game?
Fine, I'm doing all right.
I'm not totally convinced by that one. Madeline, you've been standing in close proximity to a slightly sweaty Tony for a while now. Is this causing a problem at all?
No, I'm sure I'll get there in the end.
She loves him, sweat and all. I don't know if you can see it. What nice tattoos, actually, that Tony's got there. Actually, worth pointing out, kids, if you do want to get tattoos, very, very good thing. Parents love it. Okay, I'm going to leave you to it. I don't want to distract them too much because they have to get through it. By the end of the show, I shall leave you to it and return it to the comedy position. Okay, so level 4, stage 4, we're on lots of climbing up ladder action. What's the techniques involved in this, Dave?
Well, basically, the computer automatically moves you up the ladders, but you have to jump from side to side to avoid those lifts coming up. Now, the most important thing to note is that both our competitors now are on their last bar of energy, on their last continue. So if either dies, they're out of it. And those little icons falling down the middle, they're canisters of energy. So by leaping through, they're also avoiding the lift and collecting energy.
Okay, now that looks especially like a president's daughter type situation there. She's got a radio there that appeared to be 10 times too big for her.
I think it was her dad's mobile phone. I think she was messing around with phoning Australia.
Right, this is a rather large object they had there. It's a little kind of square big gun thing there, Dave.
Yes, that's a rocket launcher. That's an exit. It looks like a box. When you pick it up, it's very, very lethal. And at the moment, they're just ignoring it and leaving it there. The baddie's got it. Tony's going in. Sweep kicks him. You'll also notice that Tony's clothes are getting less and less as the game goes on.
Right, OK. But not Madeline's, unfortunately. OK, they're getting quite close to the end there. We're going to take a short break to go to today's reviews. Hopefully, Tony and Madeline will still be here when we get back. Otherwise, I'll have to resort to pulling rabbits from Dave's buttocks. First up on the PC, Skynet. Walk around and shoot lots of people wearing Terminator-style pants.
Skynet is a very good game indeed. Basically, you take the Star Wars influences out of Dark Forces, insert some Terminators, and you've got Skynet. That is basically it. Because the missions are very similar. They're huge, and they're very, very complicated. You've got lots of puzzle structure. You've got everything you wanted to do.
In one-player mode, Skynet gets pretty tough later on, meaning it's going to last quite a while. And the new multiplayer mode means it's going to last even longer. It's not the best Doom game available. It's Doom, Quake, Duke Nukem, but it's still very good fun.
Next up, Dark Forces on the PlayStation. Walk around shooting lots of people wearing Star Wars flavoured pants.
We've seen Doom, we've seen Final Doom. Now, Dark Forces is a lot more complicated than those. It's puzzle-based and mission-based, and the missions are huge. You know, each level takes you hours and hours and hours to complete, and you really, really will be perplexed by it. But it is fantastic.
The one thing on the PlayStation version that's not quite as good as the PC is that the graphics are a little bit fuzzy and jerky, so you can't see what's going on all the time. But it's still excellent fun.
Finally, Contra on the PlayStation. Walk around shooting lots of people, wearing no pants.
For a start, there are too many enemies on screen at times, and you just can't see what's going on, and you get hit by random bullets. The other problem is it has a two-player mode, which is fantastic at times, but if both of you die simultaneously, you'll continue shunts you back to the beginning of the level, and that's really, really annoying. But it does have a bonus, and that is the 3D glasses mode. Okay, the graphics are in 3D, but when you put your 3D glasses on, you put it in 3D glasses mode, it all gets very dark and dingy and you can't see where the hell you're going. Lovely.
PlayStation Contra's still got the enormous bosses, big 3D models, very, very impressive. And overall, the game is still very tough, so it's going to last you a while. It's just that overall, it doesn't quite work as well in 3D with the complete 8-way fire as it did side-on, unfortunately.
For more details about these games and how Rick manages to get his hair looking so bizarre, log on to the Gamesmaster webpage. Address will follow at the end of the show.
Okay, Tony and Madeline King then at the final stages of Die Hard. They've been playing since the start of the show. Now they're coming up to the final boss. Now, Dave, what are some of the tactics they should be using with the big bad guy?
Well, mainly they've just got to be cooperative. They've both got to wade in because he's got two bars of energy and he really does take some wearing down. Of course, they're both on their last bars of energy, so they've really got to watch out that they don't die.
Okay, then you can see the bad guy's energy just underneath Tony's one there with the yellow bars. He's got about a bar and a third left. That weapon's causing some damage to them though, Dave.
It is. Well, he's got a sword and they've got nothing. So what Madeline's doing now, she's using this helicopter kick, which is a special move, but that will wear down her energy as well. That takes off certain units of energy while she's doing it.
Okay, we can see the boss guy's energy. He's down on the single bar now, and we're getting quite close to the end of the show, actually, so we do hope they still have enough time to finish it off. The boss guy's energy down to halfway. This is very good now, Dave.
Madeline's got him in another special move. That's a Jeffrey-type throw. You can see this is a Sega-developed game. That's a Virtua Fighter move. She swings him around by his ankle. Now Tony's doing it again.
Tony's doing it, and his energy's low. Well, let's finish her off. No, he's almost out of the bag. There's a couple of hits from them. That's it. That's the final hit. The bad guy has gone down. As you can see, there's a little bit of a twist in the tale because the president's daughter wants a new bodyguard, so she said that the married couple have to fight it out amongst themselves for this top job. So they are fighting each other. Now, Dave, there are two weapons they can pick up. They don't seem to be going for the sword at the back, though.
No, they've got a knife and they've got a rod. Now, the knife doesn't do a lot of damage. You've got to get very close with it, so it's easy to take off. The rod, you can do long-distance damage, and it does a lot more damage when it connects. This is domestic to end all domestics.
Okay, well, like I said, whatever they do, I hope they do it quickly because we are running out of time. There's not a lot on the show left. If we look at the energy bars, Madeline's one's really, really low, but she's making a bit of a comeback now, Dave.
Yeah, she's got the rod, she's making the most of it, but Tony's kicked it out of her hands.
She's down now, she's nearly down, we're running out of time, come on! Tony just finished her off, otherwise we're going to be off the air, that's it! He's done it, Tony's won it, a fantastic achievement, golden joystick, please! Well done, Tony, right through Die Hard, in the space of one show. On next week's show, we've got light entertainment legend Paul McKenna coming on. We'll see you at 7 this time, thank you, good night!